jubilant. If you saw my series last year, or last season, I was the Oklahoma City Nighthawks, and this was happening a lot to me, where I was the recipient of a score like 74-14. That's happened quite a bit last year. But every once in a while, I would have a good game. It worked in my favor, and this particular game, and I think part of it is because we took away the momentum ability, the momentum stupid, ridiculous, insert 20 different synonyms for how bad that thing really is. But yeah, we were, as the Oklahoma City Nighthawks continue to get crushed and pummeled, we took that to take our first win home to San Juan. So with that, we did really well. I think a big part of it was we game planned against their weakness. They drafted really poorly along the defensive line. And from there, we had goons. We had Josh Jacobs, and we had Eric Gray, apparently, supposedly. We'll see. I don't know. We might not have him for long. He did not take advantage of his opportunity as much as our other boy did. If you saw at the end of the last video, I posted the fantasy stats for the players in a non-PPR league, and I'll probably continue to do that, and I'll probably keep track of those in a Google Doc throughout the series, season, either one that works, as well as a public Google Doc for the renamed players as well as the relocated franchise. Might as well combine all of that at once. What we're going to do today is first hire and assign scouts. So this is completely based off of how we drafted, okay? We are going to be looking at priorities left end, right outside linebacker, cornerback. This is based off of the strength and the depth and the age, and mainly the age. So top 10 prospects are defensive ends, outside linebacker. I don't imagine we're going to have a high top 10 draft pick. I hope not, but it's us. If I were a betting man. So we have an offensive tackle, quarterback, inside, outside linebacker, in Yule line, I don't know, safety, and then outside linebacker. So what's IOL? I do not know, but we're definitely going to want our national scout to be our top tier, so we're going to go ahead and replace. Yeah, we're going to fire that guy. Confirm. We don't need a quarterback one. We're good on that for now. I don't know what IOL is, but it's a one star. Safety's a one star. And I don't want to do this one yet. We want to see what our options are. So we have a 1, 2, and 3 star scout that we're going to be looking for. So let's look at the free agents. The top tier scouts we're going to be wanting, like I said, defensive ends, outside linebackers, and cornerbacks. Cornerbacks specifically, because we can get more than one and see if we can find a diamond in the rough there. Yung Huang. I mean, cornerback and middle linebacker. If I can get one to cover both of those things, that'd be great. Logan Mankins retired and became a scout. I love that. Marines chose Drew for running backs and tight ends, which is interesting, but offensive interior, offensive line, so guard and center. That's good that they had that. I think position expertise, too, doesn't have a penalty. Like, if you can do one, you can do the other at the exact same caliber. So, not bad. Defensive end and outside linebacker. We're going to have to go with Calvin Heath. Let's go ahead and hire him for our national three-star scout. And head on down to the twos. Deion Sanders for our cornerback and wide receiver coach. I mean, I almost don't want to keep going. I mean, let's look at, by the way, Miguel Villanueva was our scout in the Oklahoma City Nighthawks franchise. Maurice Jones-Drew, Esther Matsui, Emmanuel Mensah, Elizabeth Nkube. I like that name. It's a very cute name. I wonder if her personality is square, though. Kenny Ramsey, Willie Rofe, Ray Robertson, Anna Rodriguez. If any of these names sound familiar that I'm not recognizing, Rondé Barber would have been a great one as well. I think he was actually our scout for Oklahoma City Nighthawks and before. One of the Barbers. Tiki, Rondé, anyway. But Deion Sanders, for a two-star, for a cornerback and wide receiver, which we may have to be looking at just in case, depending on, we'll focus next year on looking at contracts. Right now, we're probably going to want to keep everybody who's above 72, but we'll hire a cornerback and wide receiver scout. And then we've got a one, so we can go ahead and change this to the other way. The only one missing, I mean, we got defensive end, outside linebacker, and cornerback. If I'm remembering correct, I mean, safety is always a good idea. Outside linebacker and safety. Middle linebacker and safety. I'd rather combine it so with something that we're already doing so we can get the most information out of it. So outside linebacker and safety, probably the best bet there. Safety and wide receiver. Safety and cornerback. I think that for Curtis Caldwell, welcome to the team, confirm. Just to see if we can do another one. We can do another one, or just at least giving us that window there. Might as well not waste it. Wide receiver, cornerback, we already have. Running back, defensive tackle, tight end. Defensive end and running back. We're looking at defensive ends for one stars for the time being. Defensive tackle inside, interior offensive line, cornerback and tight end, cornerback, wide receiver. I mean, I definitely want cornerback and I definitely want safety. Can I get both? Yes. That's a two-star. So, defensive end, defensive tackle. We'll go ahead and hire him if we can as well. Yep, I need what I hire. Okay. So these are our scouts. Now, obviously, we're going to want our national scout to be our three-star and just get the most information from as many people as possible, so that is set. The rest of them, let's take a look at what we've got. We've got two for safeties. We have two for cornerbacks. We have two for wide receivers, so those guys kind of crisscross, interlace one another. Interior offensive line and defensive tackle for one of our one-stars, no big deal. But for cornerbacks, we're going to do the strong suit of the draft. So let's take a look. Region breakdown. I haven't done any changes to the class. I want to see what Madden's going to give us. Looks like the West region has got offensive tackles, outside linebackers, and wide receivers and safeties on the top list. Projected ranks 19, 22, and 23. Probably getting a safety, I'm thinking, 4th, 5th, 6th round. You want to get a fullback at the end, maybe a converted tackle, just somebody who can block and pick up where Ricard leaves off, if he leaves. So not looking at safety early. The things we're looking at early, like I said, left end, right outside linebacker, and we could always use cornerback wherever they're going to give that to us. So here's what we'll do. Instead of looking at by region, we'll look at prospects. And the top one we're going to look at is cornerbacks. Okay. Now, according to Madden, we are C on cornerbacks, and that's definitely something that, like I said, we want to improve. We have safety. Safeties can go down to outside linebacker when necessary, can be cornerbacks when necessary. But I'd rather have outside linebackers and safeties. Outside linebackers can play not only the middle of the field, but the end of the lines as well. If you see what I do a lot is, I'll take the wing defensive end when I know that I'm not rushing the quarterback, and I'll either make contact with the offensive line and then back out into the secondary, or I'll shade outside to cover the flats or depending on what the running back does, kind of thing. So we're seeing top five, we're seeing top two. The first 2 days have not a lot, so we might want to focus on getting one in the first round. Okay, so that might be our primary focus there, is cornerback. Okay, because if we look at left outside linebacker, no, right outside linebacker. I mean, I could probably switch him around, but I don't see what the problem with doing that would be. I'm not one of those guys that are like, oh, if you put your running back as a wide receiver, he's going to be a 97. Well, I don't play the game like that. Round one, two, three, three, four. So right outside linebacker would be our secondary focus, because we can probably get a cornerback with the first round. And it looks like right outside linebackers will be here in the third and fourth and on day three. Then left end, and we'll look at some right ends as well. Top five, round one, round two, round three. So same thing, we'll be looking at a few top left ends, and between whichever one has the best value after we draft a cornerback. So those are gonna be our top three: cornerback first overall, then left outside, left end, and right outside linebacker will be the next two foci. Then from there, depending on what we've uncovered, we might get the best player available that we know of, not that the board says, obviously, and then finally getting a safety and then getting a fullback. So what we're going to be looking at here, a lot of Pittsburgh, of course, a lot of Alabama, why wouldn't there be, but for cornerbacks being our, was cornerback our national focus? National focus is defensive end and outside linebacker. We do have cornerback for our second and one star. So, let's look at where we're putting them first. The red dot moved from central to west for some reason. Expertise. Yeah, I know that. All right, so. Strengths, cornerback, free safety, so northeast might be one of them. Yeah, so we'll do northeast for cornerbacks. Okay. Then for, we'll look at defensive tackle for Christine James there. I definitely want southeast to be the end that we're looking at. So southeast will be either, I could have sworn I put outside linebackers only on the three star, which should be all right. What is Christine James doing for us again? Okay, we're gonna replace her. We need a defensive end for the southeast region. And it has to be a one star. So we got defensive end and tight end. We got defensive end and offensive tackle. So not really double stacking with any of the other scouts that we already have. Defensive end and outside linebacker, that's perfect. Hire, confirm, yes. So the defensive end and outside linebacker will go to the southeast region. Okay, and that leaves the western. Yeah, west. That's everybody. So our scouting is complete, and I'm happy with that. Next up, says import draft class was an option. I tried to reach out and see if there was anybody who wanted to promote their work. You know, it's a lot of work to put in these details and to go through all the different positions, but nobody got back to me in time. We did earn 59 franchise points, and personally, Oh, I'm happy about it. But let's see what the talent trees offer us. For head coach, player personnel talents cost 10% less. Player personnel talents. So that'll save us in the long run if we do this early, so that just makes sense. Okay. What do we have? Offensive coordinator talent costs less. Defensive coordinator talents cost less. If we see a focus that we want for offense and defense, we can save a little bit by doing one of those. Again, the earlier the better. Hands-on defense. Defense coordinator talents cost 10% less. And what's the difference between defensive coordinator talent cost 10% less? Okay. Multi-week injury recovery time decrease. We only have 30 things. The first season, we want to give everybody time. We really did try to get as best we could, but we have to know what we have in our depth, down the depth chart. I want to focus on our tight end because we can get rookie of the year, and if we can get him, if it's going to be a close race at the end of the year, we'll have the advantage if we do this early and get him more experience points. So that's consideration. Left and right guards, left and right tackles. Man, nothing's going to be a better investment, in my opinion, for offense than the offensive line. Okay, that's why. So I go from road grader, hit the right. You saw how it's stuck on road grader? That's why I thought that the offensive development was the same thing as the staff modification, because it didn't change the descriptor. Lockdown machine, increased XP gains for cornerbacks. Not only would this be good if we had a young cornerback to lead us out, which we have a Dory Jackson right now, but if we're looking to draft one, it would be more potent at the time of drafting than to get that early. Middle linebackers, defensive tackles, left and right outside linebacker, left and right ends. So again, that's something that we're looking forward to in the draft. Offensive coordinator, boost stamina for offensive line, pass block for halfbacks, route running for wide receiver. That's incredibly important. Like, this is like, let's give a wide receiver trait to a running back, or a blocking trait to a tight end. Like, yeah, they do it, but if that's not what you're utilizing them for. But this one right here, short route running for wide receivers, throw on the run for quarterbacks. It looks like we're going to be going the run pass option here. Boost pass block for offensive line by one. These are all super important things. Okay, power running, run block power for wide receivers, awareness for halfbacks, stiff arm for halfbacks, strength for halfbacks. I would love that. Boost run blocks for fullbacks. That's something if we draft. And then receiver guru, equip X factors on the offensive lineup. Thank you. Medium route running for wide receivers, deep route running for wide receivers and tight ends. Very important. Boost spectacular catch for wide receivers and tight ends by one. Not bad. Plus, if we do that, we can go ahead and get this one. Boost catching for wide receivers and tight ends by one. And then jumping or acceleration, which is something I think would be phenomenal. So that would be 35. We can get this combination now and then get the get going. So the offensive coordinator has quite a bit of things that we would like to have. So for full blitz, stamina for linebackers, acceleration for outside linebackers, strength for middle linebackers, finesse moves for right and left outside linebackers. I like that. If we had, you know, tight ends that we're going to be sending regularly for the blitz, bull rush, power moves for middle linebackers. So these are already decided. We can't get to the other side of the thing now. So the defensive coordinator is not giving us a lot of flexibility. I wish I could. Okay, rocket ahead. Speed for cornerback. Strength for safety and cornerback. Finesse moves for free safety. So of these, this is the only one I feel like we're missing out on, is rocket ahead. Power moves for strong safeties. Yeah, so this would have been the side that I've chosen. Let's see for this one. Unstoppable. block shed for defensive tackles, speed for middle linebackers, strength for defensive tackles, and man coverage for middle linebackers. We might have to fire our defensive coordinator at the end of the year because they locked me out of the one that I wanted. Or reset him, but I don't know how much that's going to cost. Play rec, pursuit, power moves for defensive end, that's pretty good. See the zones. Boost zone cover for left and right outside linebackers by one. That's decent as well. Defensive back guru, gain the ability to equip X factors. Let's go ahead and pick a line here. Boost pursuit by free safety. Okay. Tackle for free safety and strong safety. Impact block for free safety and strong, but that's weird. Lockdown. Press for cornerbacks, jumping for cornerback, and catching for cornerback. Again, end of the year, might heavily focus on cornerbacks. That might be the way to go. Play rec for cornerbacks, free safeties, and strong safeties. And then hold the zone, boost corner zone coverage, or boost man coverage for cornerbacks, free safeties, and strong safeties. And then last one, player personnel. At this time, we're not going to be interested in trades. Everybody's pretty much even. We did a fantasy snake draft, so everybody had the same opportunity to craft the teams to their liking. Now, in the offseason, wheeling and dealing and things like that are going to be a little bit more important. And we're going to want to save up. Probably at the trade deadline, we're going to stop spending franchise points in expectation of the offseason for those guys. But for now, I think what I liked the most was the combination of these two for our wide end, our wide receivers and tight ends, because I wanted to get Dalton Kincaid up there. To do that, we might have to do the XP gain for him as well. See, it didn't switch the thing. Anyway, decrease multi-week recovery time, increase XP gains for tight ends in training by 5%. We're going to go ahead and do that early. 20 and 30 though. Either way, we do want to decrease the injury time, but next up will be the two-way tight end. We've spent our points, we've done our scouts, we've played our game. Let's move forward. Hopefully we, next week, thank you. Hopefully, we maybe got a little bit of a boost because of all the goodness in the world. View Weekly Awards. We got them both. Trey Lance, which, I'm sorry, Josh Jacobs was the man, but I guess the rushing touchdown. Josh Jacobs, 264 yards, or 216, one of those two. 200 yards on the ground. He didn't get a lot of touchdowns, so that's what happened here. We got the four passing touchdowns and the one rushing touchdown, and that eliminated pretty much anybody else from contention. But then Adoree Jackson, interception, forced fumble, and touchdown. Daniel Jones and Joshua Campbell, I'm guessing. Real quick check, every once in a while we're going to check in on our fantasy team, my fantasy team. The San Juan Sentinel is going up against Stimulator. Stimulator is the name of my opponent here. And I currently have 45 yards and 8 rushing yards from Debo Samuel, giving me 5 points. Nick Chubb, 21 reception yards, 57 rushing yards for 8 points. Christian Kirk hasn't done anything yet. Taysom Hill hasn't done anything yet. I drafted him as a tight end, not thinking that he was going to be a quarterback. But the reports say that he will be, and I'm not going to deny points. Would you? And then the Baltimore defense against the Houston Texans. Had a feeling they were going to do well. Let's see so far. A sack, a fourth down stop, 3 tackles for loss, 2 three and outs. Happy with my choice. Now, he does have Atlanta, which was the other money play, as they called it, and they're doing pretty well as well. Not as good as my guys. So, good little check in there. I wish it would make a noise when something big happened. Speaking of something big happening, breakout linebacker. Coach, the defense showed up in a big way last week, and personally speaking, it might have been the best game of my career so far. I don't know why Pete Warner is talking like this, but if he adds me on Threads, I'll look up what he sounds like and change my tone. But for now, do that anyway if you could. If I could put together another game like that against the Monarchs, it'll go a long way towards establishing me as a leader on this team. True. Hold the Monarchs to less than 250 yards or Pete Werner getting an interception, forced fumble, tackle, or sack. I think we can do that. So I'm very excited. If he can go up a star level, if he can become a, not superstar X-Factor, but a superstar, I might even make him a captain. I think we only have three so far, one on defense and two on offense. Scout college players, choose scouts, we did that. Evaluate prospects, set up your draft board, and prepare for the draft. So we've already done that, we've already done that. We do have to do our weekly strategy, but in order to do that effectively, we need to take a look at the old England Monarchs. And by that I mean the relocated franchise of New England went back to old England to become the London Monarchs. London Monarchs led by Jalen Ramsey. CJ Stroud is their quarterback, who's already, I think his first completion in the NFL, which was today, was to himself somehow. And I think he threw, I don't see an inter, nope, yep, he threw an interception. But he's going to be their quarterback of the future for quite a while. I mean, 74 overall, 21, but at above average speed for a pocket passer, 58 strength, throw power 89. Some numbers that you can deal with and you can focus, and because he's young, you can focus on the things that you want in your ultimate quarterback. You can make him into that. Josh Jobs in the backfield. Tyler Algier, so their starting halfback is only 79 overall. James Robinson, Zach Moss, and Snoop Doggy Dogg. Can't forget the double G's. So yeah, Tyler Algier, James Robinson, Zach Moss, and Snoop Doggy Dogg, like it's always been. Not the best runners. Nobody with 90 or above speed. So I'm not going to be focusing on the run game like it's a strength of theirs. It really depends on their wide receivers more than anything else. T. Higgins and Michael Thomas. Michael Thomas might be 30, but 89 and 86, that's a great 1-2 punch. And then you have Alan Lazard. They all have high and good speed. No, not elite speed. None of these are 90 either. But, you know, Zach Pascal, I don't know about these last two, Steven Sims and Pickens, but Pascal, Lazard, Thomas, and Higgins, that's quite a roster right there. Look at the catches. 95, 89, 87. Their morale is down, so they probably lost last week, which is good for us. But T. Higgins is a superstar, and we have to watch out for him. If anybody's going to get respect, it's going to be him and Chig Okonkwo, who's on my fantasy team, my other one, my money league. And my brother's down there in New Orleans right now, rooting for the Footin' Titans, and my jersey's in the mail. So Chig and then Josiah DeGuara. Their offense is not what I'm worried about, to be honest. Laramie Tunzel, great overall, but I feel like he was so young. Andrew Voorhees. I've already renamed somebody to Jason Voorhees in the league. Had I known he was in the league, I would have done it. And he's injured, and I mean, look at the overalls here for their guard. 68 and 60, and he's injured. So their left guard is trash. Everybody else is decent, and they have Mekhi Becton as well, who will be great one day. But according to Madden, not yet. So, offense, we should be able to do pretty well against them. David Onyemata, 30 years old, 75, leading their left end group. Shaq Lawson on the right side, probably a little bit stronger there. Grover Stewart, 85 overall, and then behind him a couple of averages, Brandon Williams and Jalen Holmes. Where are the scary guys? They have, according to I found the player for you. if you watch his videos, you'll know that Chiseled Adonis on YouTube always refers to this Josh Allen as his superior Josh Allen. And in that honor, Chiseled Adonis is on their team. Finally, somebody to fear. Jamin Edmonds and Trenton Simpson, Tyree Wilson. They've got some guys. And aside from Jalen Ramsey, again, it drops down to a bunch of nobody. Kyle Fuller, Eric Stokes. I'm not worried about it. You know, if they had a couple of 82s on there, who to see? Daron Hampton and Grant Delpit. So I don't understand why there's such a discrepancy all around. I don't see anybody worth fearing. Maybe they need an example. And that's where I come in. So weekly strat. I mean, what do we... Yeah, defend the short pass. Because we're not scared of them doing anything else. And we're going to run it again. Blitz counter? No. I'm not afraid of them blitzing. We'll start with running to the outside. Yeah, I do better running to the outside. I mean, what are we at? 13, we're number 6, 14, we're number 8. So we're better at this? Oh, that's their stats. I mean, 6th best to run against? I mean, yeah, sure, why not? Dalton Kincaid, Christian Barmore, Javon Holland. If we give him a, if we select Pete Werner, maybe that'll give him a boost, but that also improves his odds of being injured in practice, and I don't want to do that. So we'll stick with that for now. Let's see what our coordinators are thinking. Our coordinators think that we can get 5 rushing touchdowns just because last week was amazing. You know what? The chance to get 10, oh, we're definitely going to get at least 2, and if we focus on it, we could probably get even more. So you know what? You think you know me? You think you know me? Is that Raven's music or is that Christian and Edge's music? You think you know me? Allow under 200 yards. We're already trying to do that, and I want to have more control over that. And we all know what Madden likes to do is... Especially because I won. I know a lot of you are going to look at my first game and go, what are you doing playing scared or worried or conservative? It's because I know Madden. They lull you into a false sense of security. And then they tighten their grip. But can we score a bunch of... Can we score a bunch? I think we can. 400 offensive yards. If we get at least 200, we get at least 4 points. I think we can do that. Our defensive coordinator is saying we can hold them to 2 touchdowns or less. Bro, no, go, oh, game. We can start training. You have available mini games. That's right. Dalton Kincaid for a tight end. No skill points. Looks like the red zone attack is gonna be best here. Because we did the wide receiver battle before, the one on the move, and I didn't, it's probably not my, suited best to my strengths, so we'll try this one.
Let's go!
Get open, call for the ball with X to catch passes in the end zone and earn points. You get more points in the hot spot, and successful catches will increase your multiplier. Wow, bad pass by Trey Lance. Don't do this in a game, bro. We might just have to do that every time. Run at him, run in, run out. I want my points. Whoop! 200, but the multiplier goes up. That's more important. Out, in. Free lane. Come on. Another 200. If we are off by one of these differences here, multiplier increased. Oh well. Another 200. And we're still only bronze. Last one remaining. Might as well go up for the four. Okay, it says that I disconnected for a second, but I'm still streaming that. Gotta check that. Thankfully, it's only doing that on the
here we go.
Training here. All right, we got four remaining.
Ready.
Our multiplier is up. Yeah. We're still not at 5K, man, really. At the four! Two to go. There's a catch. All right, last one. We need at least 1,000 on it. Get down on it. I want you to get down on it. We got the goal. Get down on it. Continue. Get down on it. Check my thing. Get down on it. I know you need to get down on it. Did it just say silver? Get down on it. We'll go with that. Get down on it. Trench battle or trench battle long haul? Nope. Those were good. Trench battle. Trench battle. Okay, I did this one before. Good. Be off. What up? Train them to hit hard. See, that's the thing. I play conservative, but I go for hit sticks. And the reason I do that, I did not like this one. I did not like this one. So yeah, I go for more opportunities. Because every opportunity for me is a hit stick. Play defensive coverage and prevent the offense from gaining yards with the pass. Interceptions will grant bonus points. Okay. So we're just made that happen.
Down.
This is ridiculous.
Ready.
Cover stack, multiplier increase. Okay. That should have been a catch. That was Trey Lance's fault.
Ready.
Oh, bumped by my own dude! Picked off! Silver, we'll take it. We'll take silver if that's what they whatever. One more opportunity. Nope, we're good with that. Continue. We're good with that. We'll take that. All the dictators of the world, we'll take that. And start training. Come on, practice, Goblin. Stay away. Stay away. Just looking at injuries. The offense looks clean. Oh, thank goodness. We got everybody. We got everybody. It's time to dominate the Monarchs. Bam, baby. Let's play this game. Speaking of games. It says I'm up to 49 points now. Panthers are beating the Falcons 10-7. I could have expected them to win last year, but I thought that the Falcons had improved. We'll see what they do. But let's see. Not a big change from Debo Samuel or Nick Chubb. Amari Cooper's got 37 yards. Another sack. Another tackle for a loss for my defense. My defense is really pulling through me right now. Conversely, the Atlanta defense is going downward, which is better for me. Apparently, Nick Chubb got tackled behind the line for a slight loss. Playful game. Stand up, Sentinels. Let's see what our opponent is wearing. If you look at the timestamps, I always call this the drip, 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 drip. Ooh! Looks the same. Okay, so those two don't matter. But yeah, they're gonna go red and blue. We're gonna go black and blue. We got colored socks on the board? No? That's fine. Doesn't matter. Ladies and gentlemen, the San Juan Sentinels versus the London Monarchs. Let's get it. We taking it to London, baby. Division showdown, that's right. Remember, we were the Miami Dolphins. 216 yards. And the London Monarchs, they're basically the old England Patriots, aka they were the New England Patriots, and now they went back and back to the future. I should have put Marty McFly on this team. I didn't see anything special for us being in London. I guess if you show Big Ben, then maybe the Pittsburgh Steelers would have been a better relocation to this area. I don't know. I also don't care. And all you had to do was hold on to the ball, CJ. Yeah, that's what we're going to do to them. Clap, clap, clap them. All you have to do is get on the train. Yeah, the train is coming. Kicking it left. Hopefully at the 5-yard line, forcing a return. Nice hang time. A little five behind. And he's coming. Big mistake! Whatever, get on the field. CJ Stroud, 19 for 29, 210 yards. We had more rushing yards from one player. Now that one touchdown, one pick, I think we did throw a pick compared to our, four throwing touchdowns, and Trey Lance got a rushing one as well. I think we got 109 yards total. Watch for the sweep. Okay, CJ Stroud, first throw, 20 yards to Alan Lazard. Remember, we want Pete Werner to do some damage today, so we'll move everybody leftward. Boom! Tackle for a loss! Pete Werner just promoted himself. Negative 2 yards for who's their running back? Nobody cares who your running back was. Cover six. I'm going to take control of Adoree over here and kind of stick with the flat. Looks like a run. I forgot to put hit him hard as my coach suggestion. My bad. Auto alignment, base. Ball in air for the first, until midway through the third quarter when we have a better idea of what we need to do to win the game, we just swap ball for now. Cornerback matchup, balance. Option defense, he can run. We're gonna balance it for now. But tackling, I want devastation. I want to divide all peoples within their nation. Deron Payne, what you got for me? I was under pressure because my boy Payne was bringing it. He was back there. I like that. We're going to cover three buzz. I like this formation because, especially if you do this. Boom! Get it! Get it! Let's go! Deron Payne with a fumble recovery. Salah Algier, get the fuck out of here. That was a, because we're in international waters, that was a shoulder biscuit. I skipped his numbers, I don't care. We're gonna run it inside. I know that it's a penalty because of our outside run focus, but we out here, boy! Let's go! By the way, I noticed something, and I believe it was Mutt Mode. I was celebrating, and he did a celebration where it tremendously decreased the speed, but it was a combination celebration with the teammate that was running with him, and it, like, they looked at each other and they high-fived and stuff. I think that's an excellent addition to the game. I know the Madden community has a lot of vitriol against EA, well-deserved, don't get me wrong. But you can't not appreciate the good thing. So that, I have to admit, is a great thing. Whew. I was expecting him from the third tackle to get down. Ooh, I'm glad number 19 was there because I went the wrong way. So yeah, so far today, 3 rushes, 5 yards. I did adjust the sliders and give their run blocking an improvement. I do little tweaks at a time. Whew. It's CJ Stroud, 3-for-3. I should just do that all game. Yeah, keep throwing it short where our game plan is. Al Woods, can he lay it down on him? I'm telling you, it seems I have not increased the fumble rating. I just hit hard. That was a very good user spin, just saying. So Josh Jacobs already being amazing. Dalton Kincaid, middle of the field, might throw a low pass to him depending on what the middle linebacker does. First of all, that was an aggressive tackle. which aggressive usually, if you think about it like a 45 degree, or if you think of like a half a semicircle, aggressive will be whatever the highest point is when it comes into your range. Oh, they knocked it out. I had a secure catch and everything on that. That was, he wasn't my primary read, and I still think that was the right call. Jake Elliott, give me some points. Unlike Brandon McManus.
Oh, wait.
Yeah, he got 2 point after attempts. He got me 2 points. That might be an, that might be a funny fantasy football punishment for the last place. Wear a pink jersey with Tutu Atwell on it. Nothing against the color or the number, just knowing the shame of losing the game. Like CJ Stroud here. Okay, three wide receivers. Let's go into a cover formation. I think cover three seam. We'll get a couple of little bit of activity here on the left, and I will stick with Trey Turner. Trey Turner? Gimme! 4 for 4. Gotta respect it. He hasn't missed one yet. Come on, Christian. Three wide receivers again. We'll go with cover two invert.
Come on.
They're just not calling the plays. I think they should, to be honest. Okay, we're covering the flat over here. 5 for 5. Debo. Now at 6.5 points. 55 reception yards. Let's go. This is why, this is how I play. There are people who know, you bring in your line, you move your safety into a certain position. That ain't me. That ain't me. You do these five things before they snap the ball, and whether they run man or zone, either way, they're only gonna have 3.5 seconds to make a decision. That's not me. I don't play that way. I play, get him in front of you, pick a line, shoot a power missile like Twisted Metal Black back in the day, or Green Shell in Mario Kart.
Access denied.
Come on! All right, we gotta bring out the Koopa Monster. Cookie? Backspin? Cookie. So they were able to stifle our offense. They have been passing it accurately. I mean, it's not like they have a rookie back. Oh wait, there it is. Go for the boom. I should get Wiz and Boomstick on my team. That's one of the other players that I renamed Wiz Boomstick based off the Death Riders. I need to put him on my team. Maybe Pete Werner needs a rename. Seven for seven, CJ Stroud. In field goal range. I got all five on my line coming in, including Tyus Bowser on the right side. They're not calling smart. Like, if I'm blitzing, you know, get out of it. We're going to go for a 3-4 trio sky zone here. Franchise guy, what can you do for me? That swat got him second guessing. That was all franchise guy 17 right there. Nick Chubb up to 8 points. Amari Cooper up to 3.79. Yeah, they can't do what we do. They don't have the Pokemon. You know what other monster we have? Did I not get off of Blitz counter? I could have sworn we went with outside run. His first completion. Three drops by Dalton Kincaid. Well, at least I know that any of my runs are not going to have a penalty associated. We'll do a halfback stretch. And we'll get Dalton Kincaid. Even if they do move a player on that side, our line should be beefed up. I can't move him. Okay? Can I move Jamar Chase? About 14 seconds. That's right, I throw booms from everywhere by everyone. And Patrick Ricard right there. Jean-Luc Ricard. That's our fullback. And he gave him a full Triscuit sandwich. I don't know. Oh, I was about to throw a square. He probably was covered. Chiseled Adonis coming in for the sack. First quarter down, we're up 10-0, despite three turnovers. Hey, negative 3 passing yards, wow, I've got to fix that. Now, I know we were supposed to have a certain amount of yardage and have, we already have one rushing touchdown. We're going to be running to the left. I was looking to see if a pass option was available. I didn't really see one that I liked. Oh, come on, ref. Come on, ref. Helmet, helmet. Who's targeting, ref? All right, we'll do a play action now. R1 circle is square in that order. Completed, thank goodness. Who should have been had all game? Zay Jones with catch. Alright, we're gonna see what their safety does. He comes up, Chase is going over him. If he tracks with anybody, that's what Chase is gonna be doing there. Hey, a non-drop by Kincaid. We'll do a counter here. I know that counters aren't the best in Madden. They're definitely not as good as they used to be, but I personally love them. Get down! Oh man, if I knew more about copyright strike laws and stuff like that, man, there would be a picture of just blending a picture of Vegeta. Or even Goku at the martial arts tournament where he came in for a day and was just like, Chin, you've got to do this. Get down! Get down! That's too many trucks. Ricard's having a great day. He is resetting the market for fullback utility. Josh Jacobs is injured. He looks like he's fine. He better not be like, oh. Man. You know, just one of our best picks, basically. Third and one. Dislocated hip. Out for the game. Paul, no mind that rushing touchdowns was our thing. But Javian Hawkins. Is now going to be in. I gave them both a chance last week after I sat Josh Jacobs based off of injury fear. And Javian Hawkins came in and said, "Coach, I'm the guy. I am the." Hey, got the first down. Can we trick him with a play action? Okay, we've got time. We're going to trick him with a play action and then try to run it in with Lance. Touchdown, San Juan. Sunday night primetime. I thought they might have put him out at first. Kind of hoping more than anything that it wasn't a fumble into the back of the end zone. But that's two rushing touchdowns. Our goal is five. I think one more and we'd be... I think our biggest deal for this game was getting Pete Werner his breakout challenge, which we already did. And now the victory. Honestly, your AI. Not only Allen Iverson. We'll get four on the field, we'll throw a blitz at him, and we'll play some man, we'll fit everybody into the inside. Yeah, you saw me go for the dive, right? Again, I mean, it's only 109 yards, but it's a perfect, there's no picks, no nothing yet. Is this a... Boy, you gotta be dumb. Some kind of dumb. Kid did a quarterback sneak. Or a quarterback run with it. Disrespect. Let's send six out.
Access denied.
And he dropped it! Man, the only way we can get an incompletion is by hitting him at the catch, at the point of catch. I'll do what I always do, is hit Edwards, left, up, and then in front of it, hit circle, turn around and block, turn around and block. There we go. Whoop! Why did you spin that way? You just spun upfield. Whatever. Okay, we're going to have to do some kind of passes here, so we'll start with a play action. I love doing play action on first because I love running on first. It's usually one of these two things. Aggressive! Completed! See, I feel like if it's being, not necessarily long, but if it's going in the air, the longer that you hold triangle, that should be... That should be the strength of the aggressive pass. Not liking a lot of this, but... Yo, Rev! You only calling that for Patrick Mahomes now? Is that it? First down. Let's run it. That was out of bounds. Clock is still running. It's within 5 minutes of the half. I mean, you're just going to let him... Ref! My peep, the play is done! Zay Jones, another catching touchdown. He had one last week. I reviewed the upload, and it looks like Jamar Chase had a catch on a slant for a touchdown, but because of the effect that I was trying to add for that moment, that clip had to be removed, and that hurt my soul. I'm trying not to do that to my boy this time around. Then you're taking over nothing. Get it right. Nick Chubb. 76 yards. Hold up. 65 rushing yards. 4 receptions. 21 receiving yards. 12 points.
On the jump.
They got me in the cover too. I was going to do a blitz. I don't care. I bid on the play action because that lane was open. And if that wasn't a play action, we would have been in trouble. This time I'm going for it. Show the barrage. You're going to get your people hurt. See, if they didn't block me at the line, I went for a conservative tackle. But they bumped me at the line. I was like, all right, well, then guess what that means. Delicioso. Delicioso. And that was on Ramsey too. All right, we got Chase going to the end zone. If it's one on one, cool. If not, Kincaid. Ooh, that might have been a fumble depending on the time. Chiseled Adonis, man. Why? I love you, bro. We have three pistol formations. We're going run. We haven't run in a while. We're in field goal range. As long as Chiseled Adonis doesn't keep trying to hurt me. Ooh, it's getting knocked backwards. Raven Hawkins, come on now. We only need a couple of lines, a couple of yards, so we'll do another run. We have numbers, I feel, on that side. That was a great shimmy, 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 shimmy. Ref! I know that we're introducing London into our market. That doesn't give them free reign to just dirty play my guy. What kind of football are you allowing? Think about the kids. Chris Olave, 14 points. It sucks because Nick Chubb is, I have two main fantasy leagues that I care about, and Nick Chubb is on, no he's not, Nick Chubb is my opponent in one of these. I have to pay more attention to him over here. Schobert, anybody coming across this way? Yes. Stay with him. Gimme! I pressed the button! Conservative tackle, conservative. They call the timeout. Okay. So in my money league, I've got Olave and Godwin. Olave with a bomb catch already. Can I get a cover four? There we go. Bomb catch, which is a 40-yard or more. It's currently at 15.7 fantasy points for my money league. Cover four again. Still waiting for Justin Fields to take the field. We got people over there. Come on. Call your last one. Call your last one. We there! And they called their last one. They're going to kick a field goal. that'll give us the opportunity to. Yeah, I've got, on my team, I've got Josh Jacobs and Joe Mixon. Joe Mixon currently giving me 10 points. Boom. Not bad for an RB2. This is a PPR league, and five receptions. Triple lottery got five receptions. 77 yards and a bomb, like I had mentioned before. Joe Mixon, 9 games so far, 9.9, I think that. Godwin, 3 receptions, 24 yards. He's got a whole half to play. Deshaun Watson's only at 14 points for the game. I don't know if he's going to make project. His projected was 30. I don't think he's going to make it. Oh, we got the ball. Whoop. Totally forgot we had the ball. Who was that? Oh, yeah, Calvin Austin the third. Oh, yeah, I thought it was half already. But anyway, the San Juan Sentinels against Stimulator. That update, the important one. My opponent has Travis Etienne and Deion Jackson. I did not think Deion Jackson was... Why would they show this map? That's the Anchorage Black Knights and the Brooklyn Bison. None of them are in the center of America. EA, come on, man. It's not that hard. None of this... Now, they're the Washington Wizards. But according to EA, they're in Austin, Texas, not Assateague, Washington. Ooh, 20-38. Voyagers at the St. Louis Rams over there. And then a 31-21, the Chicago Bulls versus the Montreal Mountains. That too, Sunday primetime. Josh Jacobs, first play of the game. Hasn't really been able to replicate that for the... You give him a few broken tackles, he's out there. Hopefully, he's not broken. Because goodness gracious, not that we need him, but we need him. So what I'm going to do now, we'll just throw it short. And I'll just have to do a little bit more running with Trey Lance. And here, we'll defend against the medium pass, because apparently that's been giving us some issues. So on the San Juan Sentinels fantasy football team, I've got Taysom Hill. We've got 4 rush yards, and I'm cool with that. Call it. Debo Samuel, currently at 7 points with 55 reception yards. Christian Kirk has 9 reception yards, not off to a hot start. Still has time.
Ready, break.
Nick Chubb, 14 points, 91 rushing yards, 21 receiving yards. That's what I'm talking about. Is Picard going to make this one? Yup. Jean-Luc Ricard. We'll do 5 wide and see how that works. Amari Cooper, 3 points on 37 reception yards. We're looking at Kincaid. We're seeing what option Chase goes with, and if not, we're going to here. Oh, that was, I felt that. That was nasty. My opponent, negative 2 points from Jackson. I predicted this. Oh, I ran into him. I thought I was gonna get bumped and have to go around, but I got bumped into the guy. Hey, for once it wasn't chiseled Adonis. Jonnu, Kincaid, and the Slayer. Just catch it. That's all I want. Just catch it. Love it. Jay Jones having a fantastic fantasy day. Do more. We got the double slant on the left again, except we have Chase and Shakir this time. That should have been picked. Is that their free safety? Army. I would have expected that to be good. Their guy or my guy, didn't I? Yeah, I think just because of the Jonathan Taylor situation, starting Deion Jackson wasn't the way to go, to be honest. Oh, that should have been picked as well. They call that a deflection. Is that what it's done? That dude is huge. Alright, 3rd and 10. My favorite thing to do on 3rd and 10 is a draw. I've said this before. My guy got pushed back. And of course it was Gray, known only for his negative yardage. So let's do a sky kick. Let's do this. And let's go for out of bounds. Lance's defense is coming back strong. Where do you think you're going? One sack, two interceptions, a fumble recovery. One fourth down stop. Two three and outs, three tackles for a loss. Alright, 27-3 in this game. I think we are going to win it. Don't know about you guys. But my defense, Baltimore, two sacks, two fourth down stops, four tackles for a loss. They have yet to hit 200 yards and looks like three and out.
Let's go now.
Four wide. Do you not see me there? You know what? We gotta be more aggressive. Fine. Good. I'm gonna be covering the tight end with Tyus Bowser, but then only really paying attention to him with the safety if he gets beyond the second level. Gee Higgins, good catch. I mean, it's like, okay, yeah, he's a rookie, sure. But if you got two hits as your secondary option, look at what Joe Burrow's able to do, you know what I'm saying? Come on, we out here. DJ Stroud, 18 to 20. Their secondary tight end, DeGuara. Still anticipated to win. Coming around. I bit. I was supposed to stay in my zone and I didn't. My bad, guys. Come on, franchise guy, save us. Play to stop, and I made him swim inside, which he allowed, obviously because that opened up the lane. Good! Sobert, man! The tackles for loss that matter, that's all Joe Show right there. Held for a quarter of a second more. All right, Zay Jones, four receptions, 107 yards and a touchdown. One of the two scores on offense, right?
Here we go.
Josh Jacobs, Zay Jones. See, that's what I'm talking about. Hawkins, five a carry right now. Let's do a jet sweep.
Come on, set.
Zay Jones, you want to run it? I think this might work. You just have to beat one. It worked if you can beat one.
A loss of 2 yards. And it's third down.
Third and three. They're running it. Got Hawkins back there. With a great block. Did he get to the line? First, they're giving it to us. They're giving it to us. Run it. Don't give him a chance to question it. Play action, spider mesh. Kincaid and Jones are watching it. Fantastic fantasy day. So, yo boy Jones. We'll give Eric Gray a handoff. So yeah, I've got Nick Chubb on my team in one league and I'm playing against him in another. See, like, the way that he shifted, y'all can have him. I hope he's not a fan favorite. Y'all can have him.
Okay, ready?
Anybody blinking? No, not yet. You gotta get Jamar Chase involved. Otherwise, he's gonna get mad. So this is an RPO, but with long developing routes? That's weird. How is that not offense blocking downfield? I mean, 55 looks like he's blocking downfield. This gives us the opportunity to further our goal with a play action, goal line formation, and then running it with length. Normally, I draft a quarterback that I want. But if Trey Lance continues to be an effective runner, make clutch throws, if I can get him better at throwing downfield, I mean, that's one less pick to worry about. We'll see come contract negotiation time, really. But I'm giving him a voice and he is speaking to me. Another sack by my defense in fantasy football. The penalty is 67-42 in favor of me. The projection going 120-100. Man, let that animation fill it. Finish, Phillip. Come on. Adrian Phillips, man. I mean, I could probably get something for him if I put him on the trade block.
First and 10 at the 36-yard line.
All you had to do was get rid of the ball, CJ. 195 passing yards versus their 273. However, we are nearly tripling their rushing output. We'll sample it three off the right. Pete Werner, only mentioned your name once, but that's all that mattered. That's, I was too aggressive on that. I hit triangle and he continued to correct it. Callahan, Higgins will be correct. Focus on the ball. Oh, a double team. Goody! Perfect time to use the pick, my goals! Whoop! Whoop, whoop! See, focus on the ball. Watching Chase and watching Kincaid. I meant to pass it to Kincaid, but I was too far ahead. I hope so.
down, 33. We don't need the whole thing. So we'll clear the short space and see what we can get. Hawkins can catch too, yeah. We're good. We'll give him a break after this. Oh boy. I like it. I like it. I just felt like maybe I have too many formations that don't have to move wide to the set. This one is like too wide to the set. He bumped him! That was a bad throw too. That could have been all sorts of horrible.
Access denied.
That's what I mean by the one glaring fault between land that is down here. Or the draft. So whether he retires or he has a higher injury risk, either way, that's not good for us. Were they only three? No, they went for a 2-point conversion and didn't get it. I was like, how'd they get nine? Three field goals? Coming up in a couple of weeks is my division rival, the Shamrock. And Albert's upper arm fracture, we might have to go to the free agency wire for that. Or maybe make a trade. If somebody really wants Eric Gray.
Here we go!
That was almost another one. DJ Stroud is breaking down. DJ Stroud is losing it. He can't handle it. So one of the reasons that I keep reaching the fans football team is because every single one of my opponents has stimulated one of the guys from the Salt Lake City Shamrocks. Represent each one.
blown. Didn't even bring the pain that time. He just did what I told him to do. CJ Stroud went from having a perfect first 11, 12 throws. I think up until his 16th throw, there were the only incompletions he had were drop six, but then he threw one into the ground. And then now, he took too long on that screen. I ain't done with you just because I'm winning. The thing is, I know that the games are coming where there's nothing I'm going to be able to do and I'm going to lose. So if they're going to give me these now, I'm taking them. That was not a high throw. High throw was being back to the end zone. Zone fake, yet. Fake, Hawkins is going to take it. We run this play a couple of times, so they might bite. I like the guy, man. Hawkins is just doing it for us. Never mind, you could still use another rushing touchdown for our goal there. Alright, second goal. They're pulling Brady's out. Just look at his shoulder, should be back next week. We're calling a timeout so that the 2-minute warning can act as another timeout. Come on, thank you, guy. Get in there. Franchise guy is hurt. If anybody was wondering, man, you're getting awfully lucky with those practice injuries. That's all that is. Is out here. This crowd is losing it. Franchise guy, torn labrum. That might be his career. Man, all I did was go for a jumping squat. Don't give up on the play! What kind of angle was that? Oh, that touchdown, a pick.
Hey, Bronco switch, Bronco switch.
He does have a rushing touchdown and a two-point conversion. That'll make the difference in a fantasy game. Is that supposed to be like the Big Ben? Woo! That first spin was circle, and then that second spin back inside was rotating the analog stick. I like that. Rushing to the left. Let's go. Okay, got snagged up. Now let's rush. I want to use all this time. EA, you still haven't fixed that yet. That's how I play. JC! Projected 36, but still. This kind of lead, we're good. They don't want to call a timeout.
A gain of 17 yards.
I got you.
That's good for a London first down. First and 10 at the 47-yard line.
Might go for a Scoobly Door 3. Let's see what we got. And he caught it. Huh. Whatever, the game is over. We've come up with another victory. Let's see who they consider the player of the game. Probably Trey Lance again. Josh Jacobs really set the tone with that first play, and then he got removed from the rest of the game. Zach Moss didn't do nothing. So for fantasy football purposes, CJ Stroud. Completions and attempts and percentage don't matter, but I just like to say that. 29 for 38. 430 yards. We did not hold him very in terms of yardage. One touchdown, three picks, all in the last quarter because they were trying to get back. That's the thing. You get them into that position and they become predictable, and then you just, when I crashed and I saw one line to move in one way, I was like, it's definitely a screen. There's nothing else it could be. I was able to pick off a thing, take it to the house. Trey Lance, on the other hand, 301 passing yards. Two touchdowns, no picks, couple of dropped ones, So 18 for 28, 124 rating for rushing. I don't know why they think attempts should be the default sort stat. It should be yards. Josh Jacobs, even though only 6 carries, 70 yards for a touchdown and 5 broken tackles. One being over 20 and being that 55-yard first play. Tyler Algier, 59 yards on 10 carries. So 5.9 average, he did get a touchdown. He also fumbled it 4 times. Believe it or not, I think that's the reason they lost is because he doesn't have that high. Their running back, if you're going to run that much, should either have a good carry or strength number, and he didn't. He only broke 1 tackle, and I think I broke his neck. Javian Hawkins then got 11 carries for 3.8. No touchdowns. 4 broken tackles. Ricard, 13 average, highest average of the bunch. 39 yards, 3 carries, he did awesome. 4 broken tackles. Fullback of the year. Trey Lance also got in the game with 23 rushing yards. A broken tackle, 2 rushing touchdowns, which we got 3, we'll see how many points we got out of that. And then Eric Gray sucks. Receiving, Michael Thomas, 159 yards on 9 catches for 1 touchdown, 17.6 average, no drops. Zay Jones, 151 yards, what a day. 6 catches, 151 yards and a touchdown, still overshadowed by Michael Thomas. Alan Lazard, 116 yards. Which you can tell was their focus because T. Higgins, 6 catches, 48 yards, but it was pretty much these two guys doing the damage. For us, and Chigokonku on their team only got 84 yards, not a bad tight end outing though. Jamar Chase, 78 yards in that touchdown, longest catch was 37. Dalton Kincaid, 25 yards on 2 catches, 2 drops, it felt like 7. Khalil Shakir, 2 catches, 19 receiving yards, no drops. Tyler Geo, who cares, 1 catch, 13 yards. Javian Hawkins, 2 catches, 12 yards. So, in a pinch. Eric Gray, 1 catch for 6 yards. Patrick Picard, 1 catch for 6 yards. Jonnu Smith, 1 catch for 4. And Zach Moss, 1 for 2. But the best. Oh yeah, we're going to look at the Monarchs' defensive output. Total tackles, they had 10 from Daron Harmon, 7 from Ramsey, 7 from Simpson, 6 from Tremaine Edmonds, Tyree Wilson had 5, Yasir Abdullah had 4, Chisel Adonis had 3, and they all hurt my soul. 2 of them were tackles for a loss. Jordan Battle had 3. Kyle Fuller had 2, Zach Pascal had 2, Daxton Hill had 1, Grover Stewart had 2, Grant Delpit had 2, Moss had, these are all defensive tackles. Zach Moss had 1, Lazard had 1, Okonkwo had 1, Ryan Wright had 1, the punter, Onyemata had 1, Sam Williams has 1, and Tyree Gillespie had 1. Eli Apple was on their team, didn't even notice, did have a tackle all to himself, and Mekhi Becton had 1 as well. Their right tackle had a tackle. The reason I'm saying this out loud is because I do the fantasy football scoring, and the defense is definitely one of the important stats and number generators for that. Tackles for a loss, we got 2 from Tyree, 2 from Chisel Adonis, David Onyemata got 1, Sam Williams got 1, Daxton Hill had 1, Grover Stewart had 1, Trenton Simpson had 1, and Mekhi Becton had 0, so it's just those guys. For sacks, Chisel Adonis had 2 all to himself. Sam Wilson and Tyree Wilson had 1 between them, and that was it. No picks, no forced fumbles. And now it's time for the Sentinels. Adrian Phillips, 9 tackles. Bowser, 8. Holland, 7. Werner, 5, I guess. One of them was for a loss.
And that's all that matters. Logan Ryan had 4. 3 assists. Bedoy Jackson had 4. Sherbert had 3. Bryce Callahan had 3. Dennis Gardett had 2. Bradley Roby had 2. Keon Crossan 2. Devin Lloyd 2. Eric Gray had 1. Mike Edwards had 1. Deron Payne had 1. Franchise Guy had 1. Khalil Shakir had 1. And then Mike Adams is there as well with 0. Tackles for loss. We had 3 total. Logan Ryan, Tyus Bowser, and Pete Werner. Any sacks on this game? No, just like last week. Any interceptions? 3. Bryce Callahan, Tyus Bowser, and Deron Payne. Fantastic. Forced fumbles. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Tyus Bowser, Bryce Callahan, Dennis Gardeck, and Mike Adams each had 1. Javon Holland had 2, and Adrian Phillips had 3 all by himself. We did get a defensive score out of Tyus Bowser and Deron Payne. Great job, fellas. Keep up the amazing work. Kicking Jake Elliott was 2 for 3. That 55-yarder was just a smidge off to the right. But he had 1 from 39 and 1 from 49. And then the missed one from 50-plus. Brandon Aubrey had 1 from 29 yards and an extra point. Jake Elliott had all 7 extra points. We'll take that. And then Ryan Wright's on here as well for some reason. For kick returning, Calvin Austin had 81 yards on 3 returns. They had Jaden Mickens, who had 121 yards on 6 kick returns, longest only being 25. And then lastly, punt returns, 3 yards for Calvin Austin, 2 for Jaden Mickens, each having 1 attempt, and that also being their longest. So, those were all the stats. 55-16 against the New England Patriots, reverting to the old England London Monarchs. Go ahead and take a look at the breakout scenario. We didn't get all 5 rushing touchdowns, but we got 4 points out of that. We'll take that. And another regular season win. We did get 5 offensive touchdowns total, 400 offensive yards, barely. And we did allow less than 24 points by quite a bit. We will do the upgrades at the end of training next week. It's unfortunate that we can't do injury updates for the players. We are really hoping that the injury to Josh Jacobs is not serious. The message on the breakout player states, that wasn't the elite performance I was hoping for, and it's not for lack of effort, I promise you that. Maybe it's the scheme, the play calling, I don't know. Are you blaming me, Pete? Did he not get the one that he needed? Whatever, I don't like your attitude. 3 new injuries, man. Josh Jacobs, 5 weeks. Our second top player, Isaiah Rogers, 24, complete PCL tear out, 24 weeks. Happy year, buddy. Place on IR. We'll wait out Josh Jacobs. Al Woods, upper arm fracture, 4 weeks. We'll see you back. And then franchise guy also off for 4 weeks. So our defensive line, we're going to have to address that. And there's not a lot of good options. I mean, if we look at the... First of all, let's look at our positions and see which one needs the most right now. Manage roster. Depth chart. Damian Hawkins has earned his spot atop the pecking order there. I'm sad, man. That really hurts. We lost Josh Jacobs. I mean, the captain of the ship. I know we have Jean-Luc Ricard, but that's not the kind of captain I'm talking about. Left tackle position is fine. Left guard is fine. That's the defensive line. I'm looking at defense here. Peyton Turner on the right end, 71. With Deron, he's on defensive tackle anyway.
So we might be seeing more of Spookleydorf 3 the third, but not Doug Costin. Right end, Christian Barmore. So our ends, we've been working on Christian Barmore. If one of them get hurt though, we are really in it. Defensive tackle, DeRon Payne is still up there, but Al Woods was our second best, and now we have Joaquin Nunez Roches, which we're keeping him because his name is cool. But there's not a lot to like there, so we might have to get somebody on the defensive line. For depth, I mean, just for depth, we go from 71 to 68, 75 to 68, 83 to 69. So we definitely need a left end. We definitely need a left tackle, D tackle. We had serious injuries last year as well, and had to make some drastic changes. Because I can tell you, all the free agents are very, very poor quality. All the best people have been picked clean. I mean, it was a fantasy draft. So we got Jerry Hughes, so we can get a left end here. Speed rusher. I mean, he's 35, but we need a backup. We need depth there, and everybody else is horrible, horrible, horrible. So we're going to have to go ahead and sign him. And we'll take a look at their D tackles. All really, really bad. Purcell, Pinnell, Michael Brockers though, John Jenkins, Tyler Davis. Are any of these guys, they have a few mentor tags here. That might play into it. It's only $1 million. Man. And then, yeah, we'll look at halfbacks. The reason we're picking up Rita as a starter is because he was an Oklahoma City Nighthawk. We'll give him for 5 years. We'll drop him when we get our players back. But for now, we're not going empty-handed into the night. We have to cut two players to meet roster requirements. Okay. Yeah, Jesse Wakuda, goodbye. Sam Franklin, goodbye. We need the space. And you guys suck. It's hard to feel so happy. I'm going to have any injury at this point, and we're going to be labeled as bare bones. But we did our scouting, we did our awards, we did our game. So this is where we'll save it, this is where we'll call it. Still slated to win against Stimulator. But I'm definitely going to need a game from Justin Fields. Mock Draft 1 is out there, Game Plan, Elite Quarterback, Eve. All of that can wait for when we return. So we play the Vancouver Snowhawks. We're both 2-2 teams. We are leading our division, and we play our rivals, the Shamrocks, next week for the top spot. And not only will it be a matter of record, it will also be a matter of in-division record as well. And they have Lamar Jackson, so we might not have as good a time this go-around. That being said, saving the Sentinels franchise, closing it down. Y'all enjoy some football. I'll enjoy it more if my fantasy teams win. Deuces.
Game 2 in the books, game 3 coming to you pretty soon. I've already taken care of that episode. It's just going through the editing right now. One thing about that is, from game to game, you'll notice that I do make slight adjustments on the settings and the sliders. So it does get a little bit more difficult. So as much as fun and as much success as we're having now, we kind of start going off the rails. So that's a lot of fun to navigate. I did already have injuries lower than the default, and that wasn't enough, as you'll see coming up soon. So we'll make adjustments to those sliders. I will also bring out the fantasy values and charts and stuff like that. That'll be its own Google Doc. Right now, it's just very difficult to transfer information from Excel to Google Sheets. I'm working on it. I'm learning as I go along. I will tell you this, there already is a Google Doc that has a reference for all the teams from where they've been, where they've been located, and it has all the player names that have already been renamed. You'll notice there's a lot of blanks. There's a lot of blanks throughout the whole sheet, and those are places that I have an idea, but I'm open to suggestions. Good example being, you know, I looked at the Anchorage Black Knights, and I thought that would be a perfect place for Darth Vader. That would be a very interesting player, getting the black, a big visor, stuff like that. But if you can think of a player name based off of a well-known IP, if it makes sense because of the player's name that they're replacing, where they're going, the team name, if you can find a number connection, I'll put a link in the description. Click on that Google Doc. Everybody's open to comment on it. I'll be able to see those comments, and I'll be able to take those suggestions as they come. For now, be on the lookout for episode 3. Like I said, it's already been shot. Just need to do the editing. And so for now, deuces. See you in 3. Adios.